The word of God is alive and powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of the soul and the spirit and the joints and the marrow. And it is a critic of thoughts and intents of the heart. All scripture is God-breathed and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God might be mature, thoroughly furnished unto all good works. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth, or accurately handling the word of truth. With what great pain might Jeremiah have written the verses pertaining to the chapter number 10, verses 20 and 21. The believer of this church age, and who want to trample the pulpit ministry under his feet without having a thorough inquiry of the mystery doctrine of the church age, in order to use the intelligence to gain the praise of the glory of the Lord, which has been left for us upon our shoulders as a duty, as a work to do it, has been absolutely brutified. That's why the reason we find the pastors not having prosperity. Prosperity, the Hebrew word, what we can understand, is not the exact prosperity. But the Hebrew word shakal meant to say they don't have the insight. They don't have the real depth. They don't have the real intelligence that has to be given to the praise of His glory. They don't have the thorough inquiring system from Christ. Why do you go and inquire before the Lord to have a thorough insight? Exactly, these pastors have really left the tents of the Old Testament as it stands today good as well. The tents of the Old Testament, there is no one to pull it further, neither there is anyone to stretch it out, the sheets of it. Really, we find the same thing in the church age today. The mystery doctrine of the church, which has to be number one priority. The mystery doctrine of the church age, which has to be for the polytheism of privileges under the ICE concept of teaching, is not taken the place that it has to take the place. Every pastor have become mouthing like a wolf. And they want to be happy around to think, mowling like a wolf, as our Lord quoted with through Apostle Paul, after my departure, ravening wolves will come. This is what has happened today in our pulpits. Pastors are coming only for the sake of their own wealth. They want to look upon the prosperity of the English meaning, but they don't want to look upon the prosperity which has to come from Lord alone when they look deep inside, when they inquire about this mystery doctrine of the church age. It is a great pain. At the same time, it is very pathetic to note that our Christendom believers are not able to understand the real pain of the Lord, which has been mentioned for us. But several times they want to look and to enjoy and to get back, and they want to see the pleasure of Satan being fulfilled in the church, and they don't want to look that the counsel of the Lord, which has been told in Isaiah 19:16 and 17, the Egypt will be like a woman and Judah will be a terrible nation for them, because the Lord has counseled that nation, and the counsel that is against the Egypt shall be performed. Today the church age has been counseled by Lord, we have the mind of Christ, and we need to know that the enemy territories, by knowing the enemy, that we are here not to please the world, not to please the cosmos, not to please XYZ trends behind sponsoring through Satan, but we are here to please that great Lord, the Bible doctrine, the mind of Him, and we are here to honor His word above His name, and we have been given not only just to further the trend or tent or even stretch for the streets, but rather we are here given to show forth the thorough knowledge of Bible doctrine to the people so that they could come back and realize and understand the insights, the advanced life of this Colossians 1:9 mentioned for us, and they should leave behind a great legendary impact only when they're having positive evolution towards Bible doctrine. Therefore, dear brethren, you and I have to know the importance, if you're a past teacher, that the thorough exegesis, isagogics, and categories with the right dispensing technique of dispensations is being required for us to teach. And anyone who doesn't come with a great fear to know and to inquire and to use the intelligence to find out what is the mystery doctrine of the church age, that person is not a pastor in the sight of the Lord. He may be a pastor because of his family pleasure. He may be a pastor because of his family property that they have made, but he is not a pastor with the bona fide gift of the department of the head of the church, who is our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, whose primary work is to feed with the good pasture, and whose primary work is nothing but to get honor to the Lord, only when we make a thorough inquiry to look into the insight of this mystery doctrine of the church. Therefore, dear brethren, know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Which way you want to go, you decide. This short discourse, a caution for you, we shall continue in the next tape. Father, we are grateful for the privilege that was given for us to have fellowship with you through thy word. In long back you have given for us in Jeremiah 10, 19 and 20, 20 and 21. The same thing in Isaiah 19, 16 and 17. Help us to be challenged by these verses to the praise of your glory, in your grace, because it is thy honor that we seek on this earth. For we ask it in Christ's name, Father. Amen.